Gina wrote, Jonathan, how do you tell the difference between a man who's not interested or a man who's really shy? Okay, great question. So shy men tend to be quiet people. They tend to be quiet. They oftentimes might be HSP. And from what I understand now, roughly about 25% of the population is HSP, which is highly sensitive people. So they might be shy because it might be information, you know, might be, I say information overload. It might be that when there's a lot of connectivity, they tend to go inward. Again, I'm not an expert in this area of human behavior, but shy people tend to be a little bit quieter. Shy people tend to be a little more withdrawn. They prefer smaller groups than crowds, okay? That just tends to be that way. With that said, what they don't do is that they're still consistent in communication and planning dates. They want to get, they're open to exploring getting to meet your family and friends. They will still initiate sex. There isn't, if there isn't chaos going on in life, you know, they're not planning their exit clause or exit strategy. And lastly, what was my last one? And they're not picking fights with you. Shy people don't necessarily pick fights. So the difference is the disinterested person is doing all the things to sabotage the relationship. The shy person isn't sabotaging it. Most likely the shy person doesn't feel overly safe. Maybe they lack a little bit of self-love. So I have a solution for you, and I recommend this. I would purchase two copies of the book, 8 Dates by Drs. John and Julie Gottman. Purchase two copies of the book, 8 Dates by Drs. John and Julie Gottman. Let me tell you why. This book has created great questions to talk to one another. Look at these chapters, to talk to one another about the important things in a relationship. And what this will create is intimacy, intimacy between the two of you. Intimacy means into me you see. And I've got another book I recommend. It's called Oral Sex, Talking and Listening Your Way to Passionate Intimacy. Folks, so what if he's shy? You can break him out of his shyness by talking with him about deeper things. Talk to him about deeper things instead of the surface conversation. How's your day going? Is your day going good? Hope your day is going good. Is your day going really good? I've been thinking about you. I hope your day is good. This is about 90% of the bullshit rhetoric that goes on between men and women in their text messaging. How's your day? Like, that's the best they can do. They lack depth. You know, it's interesting. Well, I'm going to go off on a tangent here for a second. But it's interesting. I had a woman email me today on a dating site. And I mentioned that we live quite a bit of distance from one another. And what she wrote back was a real clear, succinct understanding of what I was saying. She goes, you know what? I can understand what you're talking about. It's not easy to do those things like, you know, spontaneous, let's do Netflix and chill, or watching the sunset together, or going for a bike ride. There's a little bit more work involved. What I most appreciated was she went beyond the surface. And this is what I'm doing my best. It's why I scream at the top of my lungs. I want everybody to go beyond the surface rhetoric of dating, going back to the stupid original book, The Rules, and start going into a deeper level of dating. This is why I highly recommend reading the book, Making Love, How to Make Love All the Time by Barbara DeAngelis. This has so much great information to go deeper than the surface that most humans are dating these days. And let me just say something, ladies. The wrong guys run away quickly, and the right guys lean in. In fact, they actually appreciate that you're making this effort. So it takes all the pressure off of us when you start to knit. Again, the right guys appreciate this. If they're genuinely interested in you and they're genuinely interested in long-term. You know, the challenge with most people is they're just not into each other enough to make the effort. And I'm here to say there is a way to make that happen by asking better questions and becoming intimate. And I don't mean penis and vagina intimate. I mean, into me you see, into me you see. That's what intimacy stands for. So that's my invitation for everyone. And going back to your original question about the shy guy, the difference between the shy guy, he's usually just quiet, but he's engaged. And that's how you can tell the difference. Okay, Gina, thank you so much for that question. I really appreciate it. All right, let's see what else we have.